we probably had the ability to go 20 years ago, but we didn't have the desire. We didn't have the push to go. Hi, my name's Josh Richards. I'm a Curtin graduate. I studied applied physics and psychology, and I might be one of the first people to go and live on Mars. I vividly remember reading a paper by Professor Paul Davies in 2006 during the last year of my degree, talking about how the first people going to Mars would probably have to go one way. I went off, I worked in a whole different bundle of areas, eventually wound up working in stand-up comedy. I was looking to leave comedy and I wanted to write one more comedy show, and so I basically came back to this idea that you could send people one way to Mars but not bring them back, and I was researching that comedy show when I discovered an organisation planning to do exactly what I was talking about. Mars One in particular is a coordinating organisation. So they're very much focused on, we're not developing this stuff, we're going to take the folks who are working on this and we're going to use their equipment. So we have a memorandum of understandings with SpaceX, with Lockheed Martin. I know that we've spoken to Boeing as well. There's all these different companies who are all involved in the space sphere. But who we actually use and who we actually go into space with will really come down to case-by-case situation. We're looking at the 2031 window, and so that takes about 210 days to get to Mars, so 7 months all up. We're going to be in something smaller than a submarine to get there. Once we actually get there, we get to expand into something about the size of a submarine. But if you're doing this to get to another planet, then it's worth it. My background as a physicist allows me to sort of look at the situations that we've got, to come up with solutions, to be able to work out why things are the way they are. My background with the military as a combat engineer plays into my ability to solve problems, to be able to repair equipment that is vital to keeping us alive. Having studied psychology means that I look at people, I try and understand where they're coming from. My background as a comedian feeds into that even more so, where you're looking at the folks that are there with you, using comedy and you're using a sense of humour as a way of connecting and empathising with each other. There's a lot of people who sort of say, why are we wasting billions of dollars exploring space, and yet we feel perfectly comfortable spending three times that on beer last year here in Australia.
Who's got a question?
I love being involved with science communication and being able to share the kind of experiences that I've had, the science that's behind a lot of that, in the hope that some of the kids that I speak to will then go on to study it further, to be involved and kind of contribute to humanity's knowledge of the universe that we live in. The big appeal of going to Mars is the idea that a generation of kids will grow up in about 15 years' time, be taken out into a park somewhere and have someone point out Mars in the sky and tell them that people live up there. That'll change the way that we operate as a species.